So a lot of us on the spiritual path realize we sort of got here because of a love of truth. And we love to learn things and we love to really know what's true. And we have this kind of like resonance with wisdom. And so the question comes to mind, what is knowing itself? And this question is one of the best questions you can possibly ask, because knowing itself is where knowing and unknowing merge. So there's no separation between the two. Because when knowing is a verb, when it's your actual awareness, it's purely open and purely empty. And yet, the magic of it is that it can know things. And this is the inexplicable magic of awareness. So you've heard how important it is to keep an open mind and how important it is in our society to have an open mind about people that we don't really understand or haven't shared the same experiences of them, and how having an open mind is the same as love. All of this points to what knowing actually is. So if we think that we know something already, we cannot learn anything. We cannot come to know it. And so when knowing is a verb, we're able to connect with these qualities of love, these qualities of curiosity, these qualities of being open to humor. So we're no longer the kind of person who is afraid that they won't get the joke and so they can't relax enough to get the joke, or who's taking the joke personally and can't laugh at it. Knowing awareness is the cosmic joke, and getting it is being able to laugh at it. And so the ultimate thing that we think we know is ourselves. And so when we forget that we are knowing itself, that that is the most intimate essence of what we are, is complete openness, then we start to turn knowing into this kind of anxious thing. So we have to know what's going to happen so that we can know how we're going to react and we can know how we're going to look. Or we have to study all these spiritual texts because we have to know these things, because these things are tied in with suffering, and we have to know these things in order to avoid suffering or in order to avoid being a fool. But knowing, the nature of knowing itself, is that the wise man is the complete fool. And this is what's meant by beginner's mind. And so if you think back to any time that you actually were effectively able to learn something, you realize that you were very open, you were very curious, you had a love for the subject. So if you learn something in order just to take a test or pass a test, then you forgot it right after the reason you need to know it, it's gone. But if something struck you as interesting, then you remember it. And it's kind of funny how in order to remember anything, we had to be open then, and then we have to be open now in order to have that memory. And so there aren't really two things happening. There's this sort of like resonance and kind of frequency thing happening. And so when you start to appreciate this, you start to not feel so stupid for not knowing things you're supposed to know. And this still happens to me a lot, especially with YouTube. Like if I don't know how to pronounce anything, or if you're talking about anything, and talking about these spiritual concepts is really difficult, because everything you say in language can be refuted or could be wrong. And yet you have to sort of have this faith that anybody who is aware of this right now, who is like this awareness is being shared with right now, is open and has their own like level of resonance. Do they have this curiosity? And so this becomes how you tell if something is true for you. And so you realize that truth is fluid, which can be a really scary thing. But when you start to understand how love is a yes to everything, and awareness and the state we already are is a complete yes to everything, you start to also realize like what things are worth focusing on and saying yes to and which things are not. And so when we become completely open and when we have an open mind and we let go of thoughts and we let go of what we think we know and we let go of the knower who knows, which is the ultimate thing that we think we know that gets in the way of awareness, then we're able to really like see our way clear and connect with ourselves and know on a deeper level, and like insights can flood in. And that's again part of the magic of it, is that when you're completely open and when you let go of what you're knowing, and then things that you've never thought of before can come to you. And everybody's had this experience when they've really wanted to know an answer to a question or a solution to a problem, and they've worked their brain so hard that eventually they have to take a break. And then they realize later, much later, in a state of relaxation, that insight kind of comes to them. And the same thing happens with like spiritual texts that you ponder, like years later, when you start to meditate or you start to understand other things or just align with awareness or source or whatever more, then like these answers to these questions you forgot you asked can just come in, and we can grab onto those and make those part of the self who knows. But yeah, there really is nothing to take away and nothing to know, and you're completely free. There's another quality of awareness for you.